I suppose I must see who it is. Who is it? What is it? Why could you not send it by pneumatic post? Well? But I can see you right now. What more do you want? Oh, hush. You know you must not say anything against the machine. One mustn't. It is too far, too out of the way. I have been terribly busy lately with my lectures, you know. I dislike airships. I dislike seeing the horrible brown earth, and the sea, and the stars when it is dark. I get no ideas in an airship. What kind of ideas can the air give you? No, I do not. I dislike the stars. But did they give you an idea? How interesting. What was it? I do not understand. A sword? Does not strike me as a very good idea. But it is certainly original. When did it come to you first? No harm. But no advantage. The surface of the earth is only dust and mud, no advantage. The surface of the earth is only dust and mud, no life remains on it, and you would need a respirator, or the cold of the outer air would kill you. One dies immediately in the outer air. Besides, it is contrary to the spirit of the age. Edward. He has isolated himself. Edward. Edward, I cannot come to see you. I cannot leave this place. Because, any moment, something tremendous might happen. Have you been on the surface of the earth yet? Then what is it? Here I am. I have had the most terrible journey and greatly retarded the development of my soul. It is not worth it, Edward. It is not worth it. My time is too precious. The sunlight almost touched me, and I have met with the rugged people. I can only stop a few minutes. Say what you want to say, and then I must return. But why shouldn't you go outside? It is perfectly legal, perfectly mechanical, to visit the surface of the earth. I have lately been to a lecture on the sea. There is no objection to that. One simply summons a respirator and gets an egress ion permit. It is not the kind of thing that spiritually minded people do, and I beg you not to do it, but there is no legal objection to it. Then how did you get out? A way of your own? But that would be wrong. I worship nothing. I am most advanced. I don't think you are religious, for there is no such thing as religion left. All the fear and the superstition that existed once have been destroyed by the machine. I only meant that to find out a way of your own was. Besides, there is no new way out. Except through the Vomitories, for which one must have an egress ion permit, it is impossible to get out. The book says so. Don't talk of these terrible things. You make me miserable. You are throwing civilization away. Go on. Nothing that you say could distress me now. I am hardened. This is unfair. You have called me across the world to hear your story, and herein I will. Tell me, as briefly as possible, for this is a disastrous waste of time. Tell me how you returned to civilization. No, but I understand everything now. You put on your respirator, and managed to walk along the surface of the earth to Avaminori, and there your conduct was reported to the Central Committee. Yes. It will end in homelessness. The machine has been most merciful. By that superstitious phrase, do you mean that you could live in the outer air? Have you ever seen, round the Avaminoris, the bones of those who were extruded after the Great Rebellion? Indeed. Ferns and a little grass may survive, but all higher forms have perished. Has any airship detected them? Has any lecturer dealt with them? Then why the softness? See what? What do you say? Can you imagine anything more absurd? A man who was my son believes that the machine is talking. It would be impious if it was not mad. The machine is talking? What does that mean? The phrase conveys nothing to me. You do not refer, I suppose, to the trouble there has been lately with the music? Edward, where are you? Is there any hope, Edward? Where are you? But Edward, is it true? Are there still men on the surface of the earth? Is this tunnel, this poisoned darkness, really not the end? Some fool will start the machine again tomorrow.